Hey guys, this is Kathy. Today I want to talk to you about anxiety. Anxiety, which can mean stress, it can mean panic attacks, it can mean anything in between. So I'm going to tell you exactly what these differences are and give you some starting steps if this is what you're struggling with. Let's get going. So today I want to talk to you about anxiety. Anxiety means a lot of things to a lot of people. So what I want to do is I want to give you clarity on what this means and the low level anxiety as well as more extreme anxiety. For myself, why I'm sharing this is because I had my own anxiety and I had the low grade anxiety for many years. I didn't deal with it. I actually pushed it off. I did the opposite of what I should have been doing. And life obviously throws us stresses, makes us feel more under pressure over time. And as that stress built up, the anxiety built up, and I started to deal with panic attacks. So there are two sides of the spectrum, but on the low grade side of anxiety could look like putting things off, procrastinating things, trying to be a perfectionist with things, overworking, trying to be very busy all the time and trying to do more and be better. Maybe isolating yourself, being depressed in social situations, avoiding social situations, anything that just feels uncomfortable is a form of anxiety. And for many of us, we push this aside because we think this is just how we feel. And for many women that I work with, myself included, we get to the point where we think that I have anxiety. I own anxiety. And this is the opposite of what the truth is. And the truth is actually that I am dealing right now with anxiety. Anxiety is what I'm struggling with right now, but it doesn't own me. It's much like if you think about your thoughts in your head all day long, you have like millions of thoughts floating through your head. Your thoughts aren't you unless you put an emotion to them. So if you attach an emotion to a thought or a fear or whatever it is that you might be worried about in that moment, then now it has a deeper hold on you. And that's when it can start to pull you out of balance. On the opposite side of the spectrum is anxiety, dealing with panic attacks, feeling almost unable to deal with life. Everybody has different scenario and symptoms. For me, it was I couldn't breathe. I was breathing right into my chest. I was overthinking. My brain would start to run crazy and I didn't know how to control it. I would feel my body tense up and I would just literally feel like I had to run and hide. And I can't, I'm inside of myself. So I feel like this grip on me was taking over and I was really worried that I was gonna die. I thought I was having heart attacks many times and symptoms continued to get worse because I wasn't dealing with the issues. Now, a lot of people will tell you, breathe, right? Which was the biggest help for me. My experience did teach me to breathe, but what I first want to note here, if you're dealing with anxiety in any form, and if it's minor, I'm gonna suggest that you deal with it very soon so that it doesn't get any more. And if it's major and you're at a crossroads of not being able to handle it, you might need to talk to somebody about it, a professional. For me, I didn't at that time. I was just struggling in it, trying to figure out what am I supposed to do. I ended up in the emergency room a few times with this, so my episodes became very extreme and very scary. I didn't know what was happening to my body. My mind was out of control. And if you're there right now, understand that that doesn't own you. And that is not something that you have to live with. That is just something that your body is feeling, an uncomfortable feeling like anger, an emotion like joy, or whatever emotions come into your life because of what's happening and what you've taught yourself on dealing with what's happening. Look, stress is everywhere. We all deal with stress. So if you're having stress in your life and you're not dealing with it and it's being attached to bad habits or maybe overthinking or, like I said, in the low-grade anxiety problems in trying to overwork and trying to be a perfectionist in your life and trying to handle everything and not really taking care of the deeper problem, that's when the problems start to get bigger. So what I'm going to suggest is you need to, number one, not just focus in on breathing and meditation and yoga. However, those are going to be really important steps. But what I'm gonna have you understand first is that you have to let go, which sounds like the worst thing in that scenario, right? The anxiety is high, you're stressed out, you're already on edge, and you wanna run from it. And I get that. But But the biggest thing, the only thing that we really can do in that moment, right there and then, is to put ourselves in a safe mental space. For me, I would visualize someone in my life that I could trust. I'd go to a place in my mind that made me feel comfortable. Maybe it's a place in your house. Maybe it's going to the beach. I always imagine that I was sitting on the beach. Whatever that is mentally, you have to go there quickly. It's like an anchor. And then just lean into that stress. Understand that that stress is telling you something. It's a signal that things are out of line, out of balance. It's not a bad thing. It's just telling you that you need to pay attention. What you're doing is moving in the wrong direction. And you can take a hold of it, but it's not going to change overnight, especially if this has been going on for years. Like in my case, it was over a span of 10, 15 years, and it continuously got worse. So I started to do a lot of yoga. I did a lot of focus work. I started to do a lot of deep belly breaths. So if you don't already do deep belly breathing, I'm going to encourage you to just do that. You know, it doesn't have to be perfect either. You know, letting go of being perfect, letting go of trying to control your life, and just being happy with what you have, where you're at right now. Because anxiety is a sign, it goes back to being afraid of something, being afraid of not having control, being afraid of not being loved, being afraid of something going wrong. Maybe it's an experience that you've had in your earlier life that you're tying to that fear of going back to that fear. Not having money, not having love, not being in a good relationship, whatever it is that you're tying that fear to, that anxiety can be built up over the years and it can create a bigger problem. So it's not about taking control of it. It's actually first understanding, where is this coming from? For me, I just never believed in myself. I didn't have confidence. I didn't think that I was worth very much. So over the years of me having more responsibility, having a family, having kids to rely on me, and not really having a lot of people to turn to, I started to lose control of what I was doing. And then I started to feel like everything was getting washed away. So just being in the moment helped me. Having an anchor. Even if I wasn't at the beach, imagining, closing my eyes and imagining that I'm on the beach, I'm sitting on the sand, I can hear the ocean waves, I can feel the salty, smell the salty air, feel the breeze, and I would just take myself there and then I would just place my hands on my belly and take deep belly breaths. It's literally like putting blinders on and not thinking or looking at anything else, because that's the problem. It's the overwhelm, it's the overdrive, it's trying to do too much at one time. So just simplicity is the biggest, best way to begin. And from there, we begin to expand on this. From there, you can start to walk forward. Because in that anxious mode, in that panic, whatever it is that you're dealing with, you can't do more than just pulling back. It's like hitting the pause button, watching a movie, you're watching a show and you have to get up to go to the restroom, you gotta press pause because there's just too much going on. There's too much noise, there's too much chaos, and chaos equals overwhelm, overwhelm equals stress, anxiety, and it gets worse, right? So pulling yourself back, anxiety is not you. You are not anxiety. You're struggling with anxiety, you're struggling with stress, but you also need to take your power back. And that's what I'm gonna leave you off with today, is taking your control. Understanding that you are the only one that can do this. Really suggest if you need to see a professional to go to a professional. Talk to a therapist. Find out what you need to do if it's just out of control so that you could take some control back. But after that point, it's really up to you to start to take action on what's holding you back. Even a therapist is going to tell you to start taking some action steps and owning your life. Understanding that if that's not working for you, if your life is not working for you, what can you do to make it work for you, right? You get one life. We should enjoy our life. We shouldn't feel overwhelmed and stressed out all the time. We shouldn't be ending up in the emergency room because we can't breathe and we're anxious and we're stressed. That's not living. And if you're there right now, I just want you to have hope. I want to give you hope because I remember in my lowest of lows, feeling stressed, feeling depressed, feeling overwhelmed, feeling like there was no way out. I just wanted somebody to tell me you're going to be okay. And I got a lot of shrugs because nobody talked about it back then. But I'm going to tell you right now that there is a lot of people talking about it right now. And you can get through this. It's just going to take some patience and a lot of self-love. And understanding that you have to understand the triggers. Knowing your triggers, breathing, taking yourself to a safe place, and unburdening yourself from the overwhelm. The biggest places to start. I hope this gave you some help today. And if you have any questions, please post them in the comments below. I will definitely respond to all your questions. And if you'd like another video on this topic, please let me know. I'm very happy to share. I'm happy to share more of my story because this is very close to my heart. And again, if you liked this video and you want to see more, go ahead and click like and subscribe to the channel. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.